We have Paul remotely, so let's run the bump and get the show started. All right, welcome. Video Guys News Day Tuesday. You give us 15 to 30 minutes. We're going to teach you about the products we sell, the technology, and the industry. Today, we've got a live guest. He's fantastic. Paul Richards is coming to us from PTZOPtics, and we're going to talk to you about PTZOPtics products. But before we bring Paul in, I want to talk a little bit on why does Video Guys recommend PTZOPtics. Can we bring this up full screen for a second, Adam? First, they have a complete and affordable product line. So they've got cameras at different focal lenses, different connectivity, whatever you need. Their quality and reliability is outstanding. They have tremendous partnerships and development working with the leading software and hardware vendors in our industry, and they're just great people, the people over at PTZOPtics. In fact, that's why we're so excited, because we're bringing Paul in. And Paul Richards is the chief streaming officer of PTZOPtics, and he's also StreamGeeks. He does his own shows. He does his own trade shows, his own virtual trade shows, virtual events and stuff like that. So we're super excited to have Paul on the show, and there you see him. And let's talk, Paul. The first thing I want to do is I got this screen up. This is really what the show is really about. And I know it's unfair to put you on the spot. No, it isn't. As the guy who is Mr. PTZOPtics Online, but let's talk about the PTZOPtics advantage. There are things that separate you. You know, you can get PTZ cameras from a lot of places, folks, and you know, for a while you couldn't. They were out of stock, but now more people have them in. But it's more than just a camera and a lens and a motor. There's really a lot of technology inside here. And what the folks at PTZOPtics are really doing is pushing the envelope and getting the most out of their products while still maintaining their incredible affordability. So if we could just run down this list a little bit, and I'm going to throw each one out to you. We're going to go more in depth with you, but let's go over them, the things that we have. First, reliability. We're going to go into it, but you guys are actually extending your warranties to 5 years. We have integration. You were first with NDI. You were first with Zoom. Teams, Wirecast, it's embedded in Wirecast. VMix, OBS. Direct to Facebook, YouTube. And what I love is if I see a cool technology, I call you on the phone. Within a couple of weeks, you're like, Gar, I'm on this. We're going to do this. This is so great. You guys are so responsive. You know, I like the fact that you don't have 1,000 different cameras, but you basically standardized on 12X, 20X, and 30X. And a little bit later in the show, we're going to talk about, you know, what's the right X for you with what your environment is. The next thing is something that I know you have taken such pride in. You've been a real leader in this for your group, and that's control flexibility, all the different ways to control a camera. There's the remote controls, there's within you've got apps, you've got integration into various products, and you're even working with other people's hardware. So great job on that. The last one, I got to thank everyone at PTZOPtics for, and that's availability. We've gotten above the curve, and we have almost every model in stock. We'll talk about that a little later. And then the last one, and you're going to go into this in depth, is there's some new features of performance that's been added to the cameras. What I want to stress is that's a free upgrade for everyone who has a Gen 2 camera later, and you'll go into that a little bit more. But if you bought your camera in the last year to 18 months, there's a very high, high chance that you could just download this firmware and get the new features that Paul's going to talk about on the show. So, Paul, I stole your thunder a little bit, but tell us about what's going on with PTZOPtics reliability.
Well, the five-year warranty is something that we're really excited about. 5 years is truly the highest in the industry for PTZ cameras, and it's essentially based on the likelihood these cameras are going to last for 10 years. So we have lifetime support for these cameras. Our repair center is located outside Philadelphia, so we're great, excellent turnaround for everyone here in the United States, and we have partners abroad as well. But the build quality is what really allowed us to get to 5 years of warranty. We have these cameras out there that have been out there for 7, 8 years, and they're just doing great. So we're able to support everyone with 5 year warranty. And basically in the industry, we've really gained a good reputation for our support and really a grassroots community of users who've helped us implement new features. So it's really a thanks to everyone out there who is a PTZOPtics customer who's come to us and said, we love the product, but can you make it do this? And I would say a really great handful of the advice we've gotten from our users is now available in the latest firmware.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's not just the PTZ cameras that have a five-year warranty. The Z cams have a five-year, your webcams. Now, the joysticks only have a couple of years, but, you know, one of the things that I laugh at, you know, is people say, oh, how can this possibly have a five-year warranty? Well, I say, first of all, they're built great. They're just built solid. They're a great product. You know, the reliability is there, the features there. But the other thing is, you know, let's face it, it's a PTZ camera, which means it's a pan, tilt, zoom robotic camera. Once I put it in a place in my church, in my corporate, in my school, really human beings shouldn't be messing with it too much. So that helps the reliability of a product when people aren't getting their grubby little hands on it too often, right?
I've even seen churches and houses of worship with, do not touch labels put on the side of the PTZ camera. But it's true. You want to set it, forget it, and control it remotely.
Cool. So now I want to go into the level of the show that can I get on this camera for a second? Paul, I got to tell you, I am so impressed with how closely you are working with all the industry leaders in our industry. You know, I talked to Dr. Cross at NewTek. I know the relationship you have with Martin at VMix, and I know the WireCast guys. And, you know, you were talking about Zoom 2 years ago. You were telling me, Gary, you got to get more involved in Zoom. You guys are so on top of it. The way you're working, every single vendor I talk to just tells me how you guys just do what you got to do to make it work. You give good ideas, but they say the one thing they all say about PTZ Optics, Paul, is that you guys are great partners. So congratulations on that.
Well, thank you. And it's great to see this list here. NewTek was a major push forward and totally changed the way we look at, you know, IP video. A big one on there that was a surprise to me is OBS.
Yeah.
You know, with almost, you know, 50 to 100 million users out there, we're really the only PTZ camera manufacturer with a plugin to control our cameras in OBS. And you think it's a free software, you know, maybe people aren't using PTZ cameras, and there are many, many customers. It's our most popular app is for OBS, actually.
Yeah, and OBS is really cool, but I think what I want to talk about a little bit is NDI and NDI HX. Why? Because, you know, we've been big front runners and big fans of NDI. Me and Dr. Cross, you know, close industry buddy of mine, yours too. But one of the things I got to say is you guys from the beginning have done NDI right. And a lot of people have had where I guess they try to push the spec a little too far or kind of cheat a corner, not do things. You guys just, your stuff just works great with NDI. And you're the most affordable NDI PTZ cameras that are around, and you're reliable. And you don't usually see that. You don't usually see the guy who's the most affordable having the best technology, the best integration. But you guys have done it. You do it on your huddle cams, you do it on your ePTZ product, and you've done it on your PTZ camera. So right here, if you want to pull up full screen, I actually have a list of the various products that we have available that have NDI support. So I'm not going to read the whole list down. I just wanted to have it up there for a few seconds so people could see it. So Paul, talk to me about your long and tight history going back with Dr. Cross and NDI.
Well, you know, it really is between our engineers and Dr. Cross.
I meant PTZ Optics, not Paul.
and I wish I could, but our engineers have been working on so many different products with NewTek. And one of my favorites is the HuddleCam HD Pro, which is the first ever NDI webcam. And this is one that NewTek was just so excited about, a 4K NDI webcam that really is built for video conferencing, video communications, and adding that extra camera that's super affordable. Talking about affordable NDI cameras, this starts at just $499, has a five-year warranty, it's powered over Ethernet, and these are just incredibly popular. It's just thinking about it in a different way and having a unique enough relationship with Andrew Cross to get, you know, the special access to things that before they maybe are available to others. I'm not exactly sure, but how did the whole industry forget about an NDI webcam until NDI was out for 5 years? I mean, this is really going to change the game.
I agree. And, you know, we put one in our conference room, so we love it. And, you know, we're going to go into a little bit further, but it's an NDI webcam with EPTZ. So you can actually pick sections of the room to go to, but I don't want to go into that now. We're going to get into it later, but I love that huddle cam. It's fantastic. And now let's talk about another company. We've done some great partnerships. We've done some great bundles with you guys where we put together WireCast gear and some PTZ Optics cameras. But talk about WireCast, because they also, I believe you're still the only PTZ cameras that have native support with WireCast. Am I correct still?
Well, you know, I think, you know, they've had the PTZ control going on 3 years now, and it really is incredible the way Wirecast came out with every bell and whistle for pan tilt zoom control with PTZ optics. Even some of the other integrations aren't quite as good as Wirecast. Wirecast has always had focus control. They've always had zoom control. They've always had white balance control. Some of these more advanced controls, three different ways to control them. It has more advanced PTZ controls than VMix, you could even say. So when they rolled out their PTZ controller integration, they were not messing around. It was designed around PTZ optics cameras, and it's a great integration.
Now, once again, you guys have that tight relationship with the vendors where you work with them from the beginning, you listen to each other, it's not a my way or the highway on either side, and you end up delivering a superior integration. Speaking of that, let's talk about the bells of the COVID ball is Zoom, and you actually have now, you being PTZ Optics. When I say you, I'm talking to Paul. We're a family business, he's a family business, so the you is the family, it's everybody, and you is the dad, so it's funny. But anyway, just getting back to it is, you always told me how Zoom was important. You guys worked with Zoom, you're in Zoom huddle cam systems, and you guys can actually be controlled from Zoom. Talk about that a little bit.
Well, this is a really great integration because it allows for churches and different places, anyone really, to control, give remote pan tilt zoom control through Zoom to anyone in the world. So think about having a PTZ optics camera in your church, and there's no one in the church except for the, you know, a few people. You can now give remote camera control to a worship leader who can take control of that camera. It was originally designed by Zoom for all kinds of video communication applications. For example, telemedicine. What if a doctor needs to zoom in to the person and see, you know, a specific area of interest?
Yeah.
It's also important in video communications and in conference rooms. It also is, there's two sides of this, Gary. One is the far end camera control, and the other is actually integration with the Zoom rooms, which is in-room camera control. So we support both of those opportunities inside of Zoom. It's been incredible, and the HuddleCam HD Pro is Zoom certified, and we're having a whole new line of integrations coming with Zoom that's gonna be announced as well, coming up soon.
You know, I love Zoom. It was great that they pretty much gave the technology away when COVID broke and all that, but the truth of the matter is most Zoom meetings at this point, we're just, our eyes are glazing over, you know, and one of the things that you need to do is put something like a PTZ camera in the room. So if you're dealing with a conference room, you can go to the different people in the room. It's not just five people waving at different focal points, you know, in the room. The ability to give someone else control of the camera, like if you were doing a training or something, let's say in a factory setting or worship, hey, I wanna go from the preacher to the choir or the someone else who's talking. I just think that you, once again, engagement, it's what's so important, and a PTZ camera, it allows you to make your video more engaging, and PTZ optics allows you to integrate with Zoom, Wirecast, NDI, OBS, VMix to make that an even more engaging, better quality production. So just great job on that. Now let's jump over to something that I wanted to talk about because people get confused all the time. That's, you know, picking the right lens for the job. We've got 12x, we've got 20x, we've got 30x. We've got different frame rates. Of course, we have connectivity. We have high light, low light. Where are you going to be? And then we have this whole new concept that we started talking about of EPTZ cameras. And that's where we've done this on several shows. You take a big 4K image and you cut out little HD squares so you can actually virtually fly through the 4K complete larger image to create HD, you know, movement and PTZ. So talk about something you guys have on your website that I don't think anyone talks about enough what we should, and that's your PTZ Zoom calculator.
Yeah, so the Zoom calculator essentially takes one important variable, and that is the distance between the camera and the subject that you want to zoom into. And the larger the space, the more important this is. A 30X camera has the most optical zoom that we offer. But something I wanted to mention, Gary, is that you can add digital zoom to all of our cameras and enable them to zoom in even further if you're using a 1080p camera with a 720p production, for example.
And a lot of good lighting.
Essentially, and you know what? There's a lot of great things about digital zoom that we could talk about, especially with 4K images, as you mentioned.
Yep.
But with a 30X camera, you can zoom in from 75 feet away and get a head and shoulders shot of a pastor in a large church. So 30x can get you between that 75 to 100 feet away from a scenario. That is a normal space. Now, if you're in a smaller conference room or studio, as I'm in now, I'm not using any 30Xs in this space, and I can zoom out and show you that. I'm using 12X cameras because I don't need to zoom in quite as much, and the trade-off is field of view.
Exactly.
So with a 12X camera, you can see more when you're fully zoomed out, but you can still zoom in to show product close-ups and do the engaging zooming that you mentioned.
And then if you're like in that 50-foot range, that's where a 20X comes in so nicely. It's just general rules of thumb, but that's really cool. And I know you guys also have some other tools on your website that I don't want to go in depth too much, but you actually have a layout tool that people can play around with also, correct?
That's right. You can go to designer.ptzoptics.com and lay out any room size with any camera, and it'll show you the exact field of view when it's fully zoomed in or fully zoomed out. So especially for conference rooms and training spaces where you need to make sure a specific amount of seats are all going to be captured, that tool comes in handy.
I think it's also nice, not every church has a huge room in it. And some churches are long and narrow, some are wider to get the shots. And it's good to play with what cameras you need, because sometimes you think you need a better zoom camera, when the truth is those side cameras are better getting the wide angle, because it makes you feel more like you're there. You know, use your zoom from the back of the room, and it's good to go through with that. Next, we want to talk about control method flexibility. Now, I know you could probably take an hour right now if I let you on all this stuff. So I want to talk about all the different ways that you can control PTZ cameras from PTZ Optics. And we're going to start with what I think is the most important thing, your controllers. Now, you guys have two controllers. You have the HC30Joy from the Huddlecam line, which we should kind of mention that Huddlecam is like the AV sister company of PTZ Optics, where PTZ Optics is more pro video, Huddlecam is more AV. Your products don't really conflict with each other. It's kind of like a handoff, because the space from an AV space to a, but the, you get the same quality if it says Huddlecam or PTZ Optics. That's what I stress. And there's the big buddy, the PTJOY. Go into those two, talk a little bit about them, compare, contrast, take over. I think you might have a demo over there, whatever you got. Paul, floor is yours. You're going to talk about controllers. I'll move the PowerPoint when I need to, but it's the Paul show for now.
Well, first of all, the Huddlecam HD joystick is a serial joystick, and that joystick controls cameras with a direct connection from the joystick to the camera. So that's kind of the old school way of doing it, but it's more affordable and it's simple plug and play. You don't need an IP address. You don't need a network. Most people are moving to IP video and IP connected video, you know, cameras and controllers. Power over Ethernet is a great reason to do that. You can run a 300-foot Ethernet cable and power your camera, plug it into your network, and then you can run a 50-foot cable the other way and plug that Ethernet to your IP joystick and control the whole thing over the network. So IP video is definitely becoming more and more popular than serial control, in the same way that NDI is becoming, you know, more popular than SDI. So from a control, they're almost exactly the same layouts. We've listened to our customers. We're on the third generation of these. And essentially, you know, it's got six hotkey buttons, so you can control six cameras real quick. You can hold a button down to save a preset, click another one, the camera goes exactly where you want it to go. It's got a 3D joystick, so instead of using the software where you are, you know, able to have free software for Mac, PC, and OBS, it's nice to have a hardware joystick controller. And there it is there. You can see that we have the joystick on the right. On the left, you've got your six hotkey buttons to switch between the cameras. And then in the center, you've got your numeric keys to call presets and quickly store presets. And then on the right, you've got your fine tuning of focus, white balance, and the automatic, you know, exposure mode. So that's the same pretty much between IP and serial. You can control it with the remote. And then a popular favorite now is the new iOS app to let your smartphone, a lot of people in church like to still sit down at the pews and still control the cameras. You can control the cameras with an Xbox controller. You can control them with your keyboard and mouse. There's a lot you can do, Gary. So I don't know where you want to take this. But as you said, it's integrated into all many software solutions as well.
And one of the things I like to talk about is, you know, I like the feel, the tactile feel. When I'm dealing with an interface, be it a mixing board for my TriCaster or my WireCast, or there's certain things, X keys, I like the feel of those. I love the feel of this joystick. And for the money, there's a lot of joysticks that are a lot more expensive that have the same exact feel and control. So you guys have, once again, done a great job bringing for technology with an advanced feature set and making it affordable. So great job on that. I want to go to a section of the show now that's on availability. If we could pull this up full screen for a second. This is, we've had shortages of PTZOPtics cameras. These shortages go back to Chinese supply chains. It's crazy. Sometimes it's a little widget inside the camera that delays everything, that makes it all crazy. But we have on USB and HDMI, we have 12X and 20X in stock. On SDI, we have 12X and 20X in stock. We're out of 30Xs. Those are going to be two or three more weeks. But what we do have is we do have the 30X NDI version, which is the same camera plus NDI. So if you desperately need an SDI camera between now and when we get them in, give us a call and we'll work out some kind of deal with you with the NDI one. I can't do it for the same price, but we'll sharpen our pencil, try to help you out of a jam. We do have 12X and 20X. So we've got 20X available in every flavor. We've got 12X available in every flavor. 30X right now is only available in NDI, but the NDI version includes SDI and HDMI. So I just want to review that. If we could bring that up full screen again so people can see all the pricing. I don't want to read the price points off. I just want them to be able to see it. So you've got USB and HDMI, you got SDI, and then you got the big kahunas, which are NDI HX, which include SDI and HDMI. Cool. Now we're going to go to the part of the show that I know Paul has been waiting for, and I'm sorry I held you up for so long. This is what's new from PTZOPtics. Now, I'm bringing this slide up, but I'm just going to read the yellow parts to folks because I don't want to read a PowerPoint slide and get everyone crazy. Plus, Paul's going to walk through it. But my features that I love is on this list, I love the trisynchronous motion. I love the focal range support and the focal lock. The color matching is real important, Paul. I got to tell you, I go over this since when we first started using these cameras. People get real particular, and you want, if my shirt should look the same, even as ugly as this flannel shirt is, from every camera angle. It shouldn't change colors. And then one of the other things that I liked that you did was locking the pan tilt limits. And the speed by zoom is really cool, too, that you can pre-program the zoom movements to be slower or faster. So you pick the order to go into these. These are actually your slides. So, Paul, we're going to pull you up stage with the slides. I'll advance if we need them. The first thing we're going to talk about is trisynchronous motion. Take it away, Paul.
So trisynchronous motion, or motion sync, is a brand new pan tilt zoom technology that is now available for all the PTZOPtics cameras that have come out in the past couple years. It has to be one of the PoE models. So during that PoE upgrade, all of those cameras can get trisynchronous motion. And what that means is that you can set the camera to intelligently land on pan, tilt, and zoom at the same time. It takes a lot of complicated math to do that, but essentially you can go into your camera's on-screen display menu. I can show it off, do a little example of it now, but essentially it really makes the production value higher. That's what we're talking about here. This is available in some really high-end Sony and Panasonic cameras. What it does is you hit one button to call a preset, and instead of panning and tilting and then zooming, it does some really great triangulation of math so that it all happens in one smooth motion and ends directly where you want that pan, tilt, and zoom preset to be. So that took a long time for us to get
that done. Can you show this one off quickly?
Yes, let's do that. So I'm going to switch my camera input to number 5 here.
Cool. And I was going to bring you up full screen, so this is all you now.
Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is zoom into this spot right here. I had a NDI webcam here a moment ago that we were going to zoom into.
Yep.
And so I'm going to go from here to another spot in my studio, which is our YouTube subscriber counter. And before, when you would do this, it would kind of zoom out and then do the panning motion.
Yeah.
It would do the pan tilt and then it would do the zoom. But now what it's doing is all three at once. And that looks, I wish I had a bigger space to show this, but essentially it looks a lot better in a huge space in a big church or a big stadium where all three can sync together and land right at, the pitching mound or right at the space that you'd like it to go. So it's three movements at once. That's why it's called trisynchronous motion.
And it really feels like a camera operator at that point. You really start feeling like, you know, there's a cameraman there, because that's how the shots move when we're watching a ball game, or if you're watching a big mega church on TV. You know, they don't just zoom in, then move the camera. It's all happening at the same time. You get that feeling. You almost feel like the camera's on a dolly. And I just love that. So that's great. The next one let's talk about is speed by zoom.
So all of these features come from pan, tilt, zoom camera operators. And so a lot of us are becoming PTZ camera operators, not regular camera operators behind a tripod, but behind a Wirecast terminal, behind a joystick. And so some of these features allow you to become more of a cameraman of two or three cameras that are 50 or 100 feet away. And one of the great features, besides trisynchronous motion, which really helps you call those presets and do these beautiful pan tilts that you don't have to do manually anymore, is speed by zoom. And what this does is the further you zoom in, the slower the pan and tilt will be. Because as you zoom further and further in, a little nudge left and right makes a kind of a bigger impact if you don't slow down the pan and tilt. So that's what this does. You just go ahead and enable it. And when you zoom further in, the pan and tilt will automatically slow down. It's great for those volunteers who are zooming in, but then trying to make small adjustments.
It's a natural zoom. It feels more natural. You don't feel like you're on an amusement park ride. You feel, once again, like there's a professional cameraman operating the camera. So you combine these two features now, and all of a sudden the experience you will get as a viewer, if you are watching a show that has PTZ movements in it, is going to be, you're just going to feel more relaxed, more engaged, more kind of within the video as if you're there. Whenever you get these oddball robotic movements that we started from somewhere, we got to progress to somewhere else, you know, that would like throw off the viewer a little bit, you know, make the viewer feel a little less natural. Now it all feels so much more natural. So great job on that. Next, this goes with that too, and that is the focal range support. You know, I can't believe we're doing bokeh with PTZ cameras. Tell us about this, buddy.
So this is a great feature. It goes along with a little bit with the next one we'll be talking about, which is focus lock. But essentially what focal range is almost locking a range of focus. So we support two things. One is you can just zoom in the camera and lock the focus. I like where this looks, lock it down, can't go out of focus, it's locked. But you can also, this is something that was highly requested, is to have a range between specific amount of space. Let's say the camera in this picture here is probably 50 feet from a stage, but then the stage itself has about 10 feet. And so if there's a pastor moving around or a band moving around, you might want that whole 10 feet to be the focal range. You want that whole 10 feet to be in focus. If someone walks in front of the camera, won't affect it because the focal range is set to a specific range. And so it really allows you, again, if you're using a PTZ camera in a specific location and you want to set that range, you can now do so. And that's, again, really popular. And for band performances, this is a yoga teacher. You know you're going to be in a specific range from the camera. You're going to be moving around a little bit. You want the camera to continue to focus, but you don't want someone in the background or the foreground to throw off the autofocus.
You don't want someone in the back making the person in the foreground blurry, and you don't want that where you see you see that with the autofocus on the DSLRs, you know. The first thing, if you're going to be a cinematographer, you have to do is shut down auto everything and learn how to really use the controls. And this is kind of speaking to that. And once again, it makes the video feel more natural. And you don't feel like it's a PTZ camera. You start feeling like there's a camera operator there. And these are subtle improvements that are going to allow you to take your production of your show to the next level. Yes, you as the person producing the show are going to have to take some time to learn how to use these things. Because once again, we're taking away automatic and adding a level of what I'm going to call creative license. But with that, you could just make your program that much better. And I really find, you know, the church is a great example. You know, sometimes you got, like me, I stand here like that, or in a lecture center. Sometimes you get an animated professor and he's going all over the place, or a pastor is going like this. And you know, on a PTZ camera, that doesn't always work. And now we're going to make it work better. So once again, to the team over at PTZ Optics, the engineer guys, Paul, just hugs and kisses, man. You guys just keep doing great stuff over there. And this is the other one. The range with the band. And what I really like about this one that's important is I talk about it all the time, but the better your lighting is, the easier focus and other things become. So this also, when you're trying to do like a band in a bar, a venue setting, lighting's really tricky. So by setting the range also, I'm gonna know my entire image is gonna be maintained when those musicians are moving around versus sometimes they'll walk near a light, in front of a light, and everything gets thrown off, including the focus. Let's talk about it. You brought it up because you're always foreshadowing. Focus lock.
Yeah, so focus lock is one that I want to show off quickly because this is a cool one. I'm going to show it with our, let me see if this is the right camera here. Not this one. This is our Z cam here. Oh, here it is right here. So this is a camera set up in focus lock, and this is a Z cam that's on a slider. So this is the shot of the camera. This is a 12x Z cam. It's available in NDI. It's available with SDI.
Yep.
And it's on it's a great camera. You know, a lot of people ask me, how do I make my marketing videos more powerful? And a simple camera on a slider can do so much. But we know that it's going to be zoomed in directly onto a webcam and this plane. So we go ahead and we lock the focus in. So no matter what, it's exactly what we want. It's not going to move back and forth. And you can see it just locking into that focus and really doing a good job of keeping the products that I want to display in focus. So that's a really great product. And it also is being integrated directly into a lot of other products. So for example, Wirecast has focus lock available in the software. So it's part of our API, if you will. And so it's integrated into the joysticks and different software. So it's something that you build it into the camera, you use it, but then it's also going to be integrated into software and hardware as well.
Cool. Now let's talk about something that, once again, this was a big one on my list, which was give me better color matching.
That's right. And this is a great one. A lot of people don't know this, but color matching a lot of times starts with white balancing.
Yep.
And so white balancing, the best way to white balance is to white balance off of your lights. And so like in this studio right here, we've got a lot of LED lights and all the LED lights are set to the same color temperature. If you have multiple lights that are in different color temperatures, you have something called the clash of the Kelvins.
Yeah.
And you really want to, you know, get the right color, and you can set your cameras to the same exact light temperature that you have in your space. And once you do that, if you've got six cameras, you can set them all to the exact color temperature that is in your room, and they will all look exactly the same.
This is real important. Yeah, houses of worship where they have the windows with the glass and different lighting, and sometimes like they add it to the back of the church, so there's one set of lighting from 20 years ago at the front, and there's 10-year-old, yes. Doesn't match. And then I also find that like when you're doing like high school sports in a gymnasium, inevitably there's fluorescent lighting, there's some LED lighting, there's some windows on the skylights. And every time you move a camera and put it in a different place, the uniforms have to look the same color. And I really feel that it makes it more enjoyable to the human eye. You don't get that little glitch in the matrix thing where the colors don't match, where you get distracted by it. And I just think color matching is a huge feature. I just want to thank you guys for doing it and give us a whole nother level of tools, because I'll speak for Adam and Oliver, used to drive them crazy.
It does. Every producer deals with it, so I'm glad we have it. Here's another one. Speaking of schools and gymnasiums, this is specifically for those spaces. Why would you want to limit your pan tilt?
Ooh, in a basketball game.
What?
I said, No, come on.
Well, in a basketball game, you only have to go to one side of the court and to the other. And so what happens before, if you have a PTZ camera without pan tilt limits and you're trying to go back and forth with a quick soccer or hockey game, you can overshoot the end zone and there's no need to ever go past that space. So it's a great way to just limit a camera that's at half court or specifically doesn't need to go left or right any further than a specific position.
I'm going
to
add another reason that's popped up that's real important with these schools and education going with online learning. They call it synchronous learning. So the teacher's got a camera in the room, they're teaching the class. You have to protect the privacy of the students oftentimes. So what you'll do is you'll lock the camera so that it can't get to the kids who are sitting in the room. Even if someone makes a mistake with the controller, even if someone were to hack in a way that they can control the camera, mischievous kids that they are, you know, a teacher accidentally leans a coffee cup down and gets the thing, you know, this way you can limit where the movement is and you can support and protect the privacy of people who maybe don't want to be on the camera. So cool feature, love it. I put up the chart again. If we could bring it up full screen, I talked about the stuff I like the best. This is your chance to kind of wrap up the new features, Paul, and just talk for a couple of seconds, couple of minutes on what you have here. Maybe you want to tell us about stuff that you're working on that'll be, nah, but that's not what this show is. Let's just talk about these new features because they're so new.
Well, what I'll say is that these really do truly come from our customers. So thank you to everyone who's out there, who's joined the Facebook group on for PTZ Optics Pals. It's from you guys who we say, you know, do you want this feature? Do you want that feature? What's the one feature you need? And it really comes from, it's a new breed of folks, Gary. You know, people who are saying, I didn't realize I was going to be a PTZ camera operator for my church, but now that's my job, you know? Yeah. And they're saying, I need trisynchronous motion. I need speed by zoom. I need to lock the focal range. And so this truly comes
I guarantee no one said they needed it like that because no one knows what the words were, but they were describing the problem to you.
Yes, it's true. And there were a few super technical gurus out there who were trying to explain to me the trigonometry of the curve of how to make this trisynchronous motion work. And I said, I don't get it, but our engineers do. And, you know, it took a while and, you know, we're bringing more and more to the firmware all the time, but these are major upgrades. You might not even know that you need this right now, but when you start heavily using a PTZ camera, you realize that these features come into play.
Well, you know what's going to happen, Paul? The people who get into PTZ cameras now with this feature set in place will just take it as a natural thing. They won't even understand it. Those of us who've been around for a while, who knew the frustrations of some shots, of some motions, of some studios or some rooms, are gonna love this as the features they can't live without. And people who get into PTZ now, let's say, or in the winter, who look back at stuff that was done before this technology, they are gonna be like, what were these guys thinking? I mean, this looks like, I don't wanna say it looks bad because it was what the technology could give us, but it makes it such a more natural feeling. And that, we gotta engage people. And anything that happens that makes the human mind think, this doesn't seem natural, it doesn't seem right, is a way for people to get disengaged. You know, one of the biggest things having nothing to do with PTZ cameras is audio. Throw your audio sync off, even a frame, and it makes it almost impossible for people to watch a video. Well, I find that when I see herky jerky crazy camera movements, I get into the same thing. When I see natural camera movements, much easier. Even when the guy's panicking and he realizes, oh, I have to move this thing manually, he jumps over the joystick and does it, it's not going to look like, it's going to look so much better. So I just think those are great jobs. Paul, I knew we were going to run over. I said we have to keep it to a half hour, 37 minutes, which could be the shortest show you and I ever done together. So thank you very much. We covered a whole bunch of ground. Guys, if we can bring it up once again, I want to stress 5-year warranty on PTZ Optics, PTZ cameras. Now, this is remarkable. There are a lot of these cameras brought in from a lot of different places. Well, really from China, but by different vendors and brands. No one's got a 5-year warranty except for PTZ Optics because you know how well your stuff is built. You know it's built to last. You know it's got quality. It's got features. It's got affordability. And it's got the best warranty in the business. And just kudos to the folks at PTZ Optics. You've done it again, Paul.
Thank you, Gary. Thank you for having me on. It's been a lot of fun.
Cool.
We'll leave it at that. I have some new stuff to bring to you soon, but we'll leave it at that for today.
Last time I got into that, you got in trouble, so did I. So we'll have that as a different show that we can heavily edit and redact. All right, guys. Thanks a lot. If you could just bring it up to me in the screen now, Paul, thank you so much. Great job. And watch Paul's Stream Beak show. He does a great job. If you're on social media, you see him more than you see me. So great job, Paul.
Thanks, Gary.
All right, what do we got coming up next week? Shogun 7, best Shogun ever, an Atomos show. We haven't done a show on Atomos field recorders in a while. They just keep getting better and better. Atomos has new features. Atomos has got some new products. Atomos has got some new it's going to be a great show. You're going to love it. It's just going to be me going over the products, I think. And then the following week, we are kicking off NDI November. For the first 2 weeks of November, if you could bring this up full screen for me, Adam, we are going to be focused on NDI, NDI products, NDI workflows, NDI technology. We're going to be talking to leaders in our industry about NDI. We're going to be showing you workflows. We're going to be talking to a whole bunch of people. We're even hoping to have a round panel discussion sometime towards the end of the two-week period. So get ready, folks. We're going to do Atomos next week and then hunker down for 2 weeks of heavy NDI knowledge coming at you from the video guys. All right, I want to recap the availability slide. If you could bring that up full screen again, Paul, Adam. PTZ Optics cameras are in stock. 12X we have available, USB HDMI, SDI, and NDI HX. 20Xs we have available in USB HDMI, SDI, and NDI HX. On the 30X, we are out of SDIs. We're not going to see SDIs for another 2 or 3 weeks, but we do have the NDI available, 30X NDI, and that has the same SDI and HDMI connectivity plus NDI. If you really need a 30X camera and you're in a pinch, give us a call. We'll cut you a deal. I'm not going to be able to sell it to you the same price as the SDI one, but we're going to give you a deal. Can't talk about it other than give us a call and we'll get you what you have to do. We have plenty of 30X NDIs in stock. That wraps up our show, folks. Thank you so much. Paul was a fantastic guest today. So excited when we could talk about a vendor who's a leader in our industry. And I said it several times during the show, and I'm going to stress it again. Why do we love PTZ Optics cameras so much? Affordability, features, performance, reliability. 5-year warranty, folks, now. PTZ Optics, we love them. Paul did a great job on the show. This is Gary from Video Guys. Like us on Facebook, social media, Twitter, YouTube. Like our videos, share our videos wherever you see them. Thank you so much, guys. Peace.
Video Guys is available Monday through Friday. Give us a call at 1-800-323-2325. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Instagram to stay connected with all of our updates. And you can like us on Facebook. Keep an eye out for our live videos. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.